I've closed both of my tables, and I'm now going to create a query. Queries let us select specific information and manipulate data from one or more tables. To create a query, we're going to click on the table pets to select it. Then we're going to go to the Create tab in the ribbon. In the Create tab, I'm going to select Query Wizard from the Query section. This gives me the option of several different types of queries. I'm going to click on the first query, Simple Query Wizard, and hit OK. I'm going to choose Table TBL Pets, which is one of the two options that I have, and I'm going to hit the double arrow button to move all of the fields into the selected fields. Then I'm going to click on the next button. I have two options, a detail query or a summary query. I'm going to choose detail and hit next. I'm going to choose finish so that I can view the query. Since we selected every single field, this looks exactly the same as the table. Let's go look at the design view so we can do some modifications to the query. If you click on the Home tab, you can see that we have a design view option here, just like we did when we created the tables. By clicking on the design view, you can see the way the query was designed. We have many options in the query. We can choose to sort in ascending or descending levels. So I've chosen ascending based on the breed. And if I run the query with the exclamation point, you'll see that it's alphabetically sorted by breed. We also have the option to select specific data. So I'm going to go back into design view, and I'm going to look for myself. So I'm going to type in owner first name, Mary, and I'm going to hit on the home key. Let me hit enter first. I'm going to hit under query design tools, sorry about that, run. And that brings up only my entry. If we have multiple entries, I'm going to return to design view, it will bring up every matching entry. So if I'm looking under breed and type in mixed and hit enter, notice that it puts quotes around the word mixed. That ensures that you only get an exact match for the whole word. I'm going to choose run, and that will bring up both of the mixed breed animals, one dog and one cat. If I only wanted to get John Doe's cat, I could sort additionally by any of these other fields. I'm going to go back to design view. When you have two criteria that are listed in the same row, it must make both of these criteria true. It's considered an AND evaluation for it to show up. That gives me just John Doe. I'm going to remove those criteria, and I'm going to put in Mary or Matt, because I know that there's a Matt in there. And then I'm going to run. When you do this, you're using two different rows, which means if any of these are true, it's an OR evaluation. If it's Mary or Matt or Josh, that one's not in there. Yeah, it was. They'll all show up. There is something a little tricky about this. Sometimes when you're using multiple tables, the data that you think is there is not actually there. For example, when I want to look up the kind of pet, I could look up dog. But I get a data type mismatch. This is happening because we are actually looking up dog from another table. When we go to relationships, we see that it's the ID that links to kind of pet, not the actual kind of pet. So if I go back to the table pets query and put in the number 1, which is our ID, I'm not sure which one's an ID for, and then run it, that will bring me all of the dogs. Well, that's not very intuitive, so there's other ways to deal with that. So when I go back to the design view, I can right click and choose show table, and I can bring up table kind of pet. Now I have both of these available to me, and so I can bring up kind of pet by double clicking on it, not have this show because it's having the numbers. And I can even change the order or take this out. And I could rearrange this if I wanted it to be in another spot. Now I'm getting the kind of pet, and I can look up dog. And I can have it run, and dog shows up. So what's happening there is that these are all looking at the table pets table. This is looking at the kind of pet table, which allows me to use dog instead of the number that's represented here. Now I can look up dog, and I can look up mixed, which should allow me to see mixed breed dogs. I want you to run this query, and you should get one mixed breed dog, and then you can take a picture of this query and hand it in. You're going to have one final query, which is called a parameter query. This allows access to ask you a question. And how it works is you put in a square bracket and type in what kind of pet. Whatever you type in is what's going to appear on the screen when I run the query. So instead of having to create a lot of different queries, if I want to be able to look up cats, dogs, birds, I can just have access ask me what kind of pet I want it to look up. So when I run the query, this will appear. I can type in cat, and then I will get that response. Go into the design view and run the query again and take a picture that shows that you're entering the parameter value. So using your snipping tool, you'll capture this much of the screen and hand it in.